Namaskar, welcome back to my channel. This is Aditya, another investment property tour. I'm actually heading to my client's property. She purchased recently, it's a two bedroom, one bath bungalow, but she's doing a really strategic renovations that add huge value to the property, which means a lot more money into her pocket. So come check out the tour with me and also learn what kind of renovations she is doing, because that will help you if you're buying an investment property or if you're buying any house to make money. Then this video is for you.
Hey, oh, Rama, hi, how are you?
I'm good, how are you?
Oh, you're good.
Coming in.
With the COVID style.
Yep.
No, we are excited. Thank you for having us.
Yeah, same here, no problem. How are you?
Very good, doing very good. How are you?
I'm doing good. Better now.
Are you ready to show this property for us?
Oh, of course. I would love to.
So, just before we tour the property, can you tell us a little bit about this property?
Yes, so we purchased this house, and thank you so much for helping me out here.
You're welcome.
We bought this house for 330, and it was two bedroom, one bathroom, unfinished basement.
So it's a two bedroom, one bath on the main floor.
Main floor, raised ranch, two bedroom, one bathroom, and unfinished basement.
Unfinished basement. Oh, that's awesome. So pretty much you bought it. A bungalow, two bedroom, one bath.
Yes.
That's it.
So
now you're updating the whole house?
Yes. So as you can see, we are renovating the whole main floor. So there was a lot of empty space in the house and extra square feet. So we decided to go with the third bedroom, as you can see on behind you. And we renovated the kitchen and the bathroom and other like paint and all that.
Awesome. And also what you're doing, cool thing is you're adding a secondary unit in the basement.
Yes.
So we're going to talk about that at the end.
Yeah, that's a big
thing. So give us a tour. Show us what exactly you're doing in this project.
Okay, sure. Come on in. Okay, so as you can see, this is going to be a living room area as you walk in.
Come a little closer.
So this is, as you walk in from the front foyer, this is going to be a living room area. And we are just gonna do the paint and nothing extra fancy in here.
Okay.
And if you can come this way. So this is the extra bedroom we added right here. So this is gonna be our third bedroom now with a small closet, whatever we can fit in here, but it's still like, you know, 9.5 by 10.5. So very decent sized bedroom. Then if you walk this way, this is our kitchen area. So the kitchen was very old, so we basically
updating the whole
took
kitchen.
The whole kitchen apart. I take it out and then we
Looks beautiful.
So we went for like high cabinets there and a really nice fancy little island here as well.
Redid the flooring?
So we didn't actually.
So you kept the flooring?
Yeah, we kept the flooring.
Smart.
We didn't want to spend extra money on it because the tiles are pretty new. So we
did you open this up or was it already open?
This was open already. We didn't do anything here except we actually, the whole house, because it's an old bungalow, we had the arches on the hallway, so we took that apart and made it more modern.
Make it like modern.
Yeah, so like we modernized it a little bit. So
and you still kept the flooring even here?
Flooring, tiles and hardwood, we decided to keep it because it looks pretty okay for now.
Yeah.
And maybe in future we'll change it.
Yeah.
Not right now.
Very smart move though.
It's
come in. Let's
so
see this
one. So this is the bathroom. So we didn't do much in the bathroom, but we definitely renovated the bathtub and put some tiles on the top as well. And we will be changing the vanity, putting a floating vanity in here to make it look more modern looking.
Wow, very economical renovation.
Yes.
So pretty much you kept the flooring.
Yes.
And you're changing the toilet, vanity.
And we put the tiles on the top of the bathtub. Because
and you didn't even change the tub.
The tub is pretty good condition, so we decided to keep it.
How much money are you spending on this tub roughly?
Maybe $700.
$700. Oh my god, I love that.
Yeah.
So that's one thing, guys. You always need to be strategic with your renovations because you're not going to live in this house. And if it's usable for another couple of years, right?
Yes. And plus, realizing like everything is pretty good. I mean, you just need a paint and then the tile work is already done, as you can see, and it just changed the whole look of the bathroom.
Yeah, so many people ask me what are the things that really add value. What she did exactly, making the washroom modern. You don't have to be like go crazy, redo the whole washroom.
Yeah, I totally agree.
Yes, and painting. And I don't know if you guys noticed, she did all the pot lights. You changed that, right?
Yes, that is a big thing, because I think even putting the pot light just changed the whole look of the house.
Yeah.
And it just like make it so bright and modern. So
that I agree 1000%.
That was a good decision we made to change it.
And also if you noticed, the pot lights are only in the living area.
Yes.
Not in the bedroom. So
you don't need a pot light in the bedroom. You need one light. So here we didn't change anything. We will be putting a new blind and we will be changing the light, of course, and paint. That's it. Nothing else.
So just painting, blinds, lights.
Yeah, and the same thing in this bedroom as well. So no changes, just the paint. Of course, the light, we will be putting an LED light, and that's about it. The only thing we did in this bedroom was there was no attic. They actually covered the attic access, so we had to put it back again.
Okay, so that's pretty smart. So they didn't even have access.
No,
or they closed it.
They closed it. When they did a renovation, they closed it. So we opened it back again and we needed the access again.
You need the access, guys.
Oh, of course. Yeah.
So if you notice there is no attic in your house, make sure to find out where it is and open it up, because if you want to do insulation or if there is any leak in the roof, you need to get in there. So be aware. That's a very good point.
And windows are pretty much new, so we decided to keep them for now.
So yeah, they look vinyl.
They are vinyl and they're pretty good shape. So
So before we go into the basement, which is the main element, I know I'm excited to learn more on the duplex conversion, that unit. But before that, on the main floor, this kitchen looks super beautiful for me now.
Thank you.
Tell me, what did you do? What are the things that you changed and how much would it cost you?
Of course. So this kitchen was very, very old, like original 60s kitchen. So we took everything out.
Okay.
So the walls were like a plaster wall. So we decided to rip the walls off too and put the nice like drywall on the walls to make it like, you know, more modern. And we had like a huge bulkheads on the top, so we ripped that off, open it up, and then we insulated properly. And then, of course, as you can see, we installed the new kitchen cabinets, green countertop.
Pretty much the new things look super modern.
Yes.
I'm just curious, how much did you spend on them?
I would say we spent around 5500 total, including granite.
5500 for granite countertop, the kitchen cabinets, backsplashes,
island, and tap and sink including.
Perfect. I love that. That's a very strategic renovations, guys. So the money you're going to spend on kitchen, it's not going anywhere. But at the same time, if you spend 20,000, you're not getting it back, right? And
exactly. I mean, you can spend 50,000 on a kitchen, but it's not it's not needed.
Yeah. So very strategy. Cabinets, backsplashes, countertop, sink makes a difference.
Yeah.
And then pot lights, of course, in the kitchen and living.
Yeah. And then we put this restaurant style, like really modern tap in here, the faucet in here.
I love
that. It looks really, really
stylish. I love the granite color too.
Thank you.
So let's go into the basement and tell us more there.
All right.
So how do you like the tour so far? Let me know in the comments below. Thumbs up or thumbs down, or have you done this kind of renovations in your property? What kind of things have you done that added value, increased your property value? Let me know in the comments below. Love to hear. So we went into the basement, we checked out the basement. Currently, it's just wide open. There is nothing in there. But the pretty cool thing is she got ADU permits. That means to convert that basement into a legal unit, a two-bedroom unit that can produce another $1,400-$1,500 rent. So she got the permits in 3 weeks and she told us the whole process. But you know, if I put that in this video, it's going to be too long. So that's why I decided to put it in the next video. So watch out for that. Until then, check out the other tours. Hope you enjoyed this one. See you in the later videos. Have a wonderful day.